Hello, all greetings. This is Gilles Mancillon. I thought I'd come and say hello to you today. I wanted to discuss very briefly certain ideas about spirituality, of course, and also about astrology. I will get to that afterwards. I wanted to say that in terms of spirituality, that there are people that are looking to elevate their consciousness, to reach a higher plane of reality, a conscious reality. And then there are those who are not interested. For anyone who's not really interested in spiritual ascension, I will always advise them to focus, to keep a focused attention on what they want in order to anchor that within themselves and create a better, an easier flow, in a receptive flow, in order to receive that which we want. And that is true also if we believe in spirit. So focus attention is extremely important, and to know what to seek, to ask what we want, in order to find what we seek. However, there is a many understanding that love and passion can also create attachment. Attachment creates fear and anger. So it is important to love and to desire things without having this attachment to immediate result, and so to allow and trust that the universe can bring it to you without having to be able to let go of attachment. For there is this great law of one, the law of attraction, the law that one is all and all is one. And so in a sense, in terms of spiritual ascension, this understanding tells you that the presence of spirit is within all self, life is in all things. Life is a sacred life process. You are sacred. Everything is sacred. You can see the presence of Christ, Buddha, Allah, Yahweh in a tree, in a bird, in the sky. It is everywhere. It is just a matter of opening our consciousness to certain frequency and level of consciousness. And for that, we need to follow our intuition, to tune into the inner process of the heart, because there are many doctrines, many ways of ascension, many paths, many spiritual teacher guides in the books and all kinds of old teachings, new teachings. But in a sense, it's when we move into that connection that we find the guidance, and when we can be led to that which is that path. Until then, it will remain it will continue to remain a mental process. So As in the past of yoga in essence is the communion with the absolute, just as the Quran said, life is a deal between you and God and the law of one. And so, but in essence, there is only God, and the false ego that needs to return to that hides the divine soul. There is many ways to conceive that creator. For me, some of them, there is many ways: the Father, Mother, God of our universe, the Supreme Being, or the Paradise Father. In a sense, all those great divinity are Godheads. They are fulfilling the function of parenting the human soul to higher planes. So it does not matter which way you choose, whether you. All those beings are divine, and there is only one great source that connects all of it, all of us, that is us, that is our true nature. In a sense, it is very important when we seek to do meditation, or that when we seek spirituality, is to turn our thoughts as much as possible to the Supreme Being, to the source of all creation, for the Supreme Being is the God of time and space. And so as we turn that, the more we do that, the more we recognize that God is real, the easier it is for God to manifest within ourselves, for God is in all things, yet God lives in his own universe, in the universe of supreme, ultimate, absolute and infinite reality. And that is what we seek to reintegrate, return to, the source of all. But it's in a sense we have to call on to that. We have to bring those energies. We have to disconnect all the limited belief that prevents us from seeking that. And sometimes it requires certain effort, certain sacrifice. There are many ways to the truth. All truths will lead to that, but some of them are quicker than others. For there are people that are seeking ascension without the recognition of God and spirit, but it's extremely painful and difficult to move into ascension on a non-person without recognizing God as a person. For it is a lot easier as a person to communicate with other person, and God is a person, as you recognize that whichever person you seek to communicate with or to commune with. It will definitely make it easier to believe that, because then you can realize it, and then you can make that connection and real and solid within yourself. And as you do that, life will change and move on to a higher level. That's really what the essence of what I wanted to express on that level. Let me see if I took a note today. I wanted to make sure I wanted to express that. So it is important to cultivate that connection. Of course, for something to be real, you have to make it real, to accept it as a reality. Until we can accept that there is an eternal life that we do not know yet. The easier it will. If we do not accept that, it will not happen for us. Those who are pure atheists that do not believe that will have to be reborn again and again and again and again and again and again until they accept eternal life. And if at the last moment of their life they think of the Supreme Being, they will be led there. So that is in essence what some of the great religion, like the Bhagavad-gita, for instance, explain. When Lord Krishna explained that to in his conversation, there are many, many aspects of divinity that are available to us, for the universe is infinite. We cannot limit God. We have limitation in our perception, but God is not limited. God has no form, no aspect. He is all. It is within all. And yet he is personified in many ways, and he can do whatever he chooses to do. So it is very much about establishing this relationship of love and friendship with your source, with your creator, to know you can trust that. God should become your best friend, and once you are connected to that source, then nothing becomes impossible, really. For God has no limit, He's almighty. In terms of astrology, it's the same thing. I wanted to it's a belief. If somebody does not believe in astrology, he will not be affected consciously. Yet on the astrological level, we have come to understand that there is this this energy, the planets have forces and energy that condition the human collective consciousness. And so as we believe that, those becomes more solid within ourselves and begin to affect us. Usually the approach to astrology is that we listen to astrologers that have analyzed charts and can analyze the conversation of the planets in relationship to attribution that we have been given to those planets or received from those planets. What I wanted to say on that level is that it is also, if it can help you in unity consciousness, there is no separation between you and anything else. For that is the outcome of all life, is to become one with the one that is all. But I wanted to provide a certain understanding in relationship to that, is that those planets are very powerful beings as celestial bodies, but they are connected to immortal consciousness, such as the in essence the Olympian gods and many other different forms of beings. But once you understand that those beings are communicating through those planets, you can draw on a communication, and they can help you regain a lot more of your own power through the direct communication with those planets, rather than having to go through an interpreter that will give you a more general idea. So the planet will come into your consciousness at the right time in the right way. So in order to remind you of things, or guide you, or help you to create a greater connection, because we are moving towards a golden age. There will be a lot of black and white energies that will continue to be here until humans are ready to let go of all that, and then we'll move into the love and unity of source. There's been many golden age in the past. But it wasn't meant to stay. This one that will be coming is the golden age that will lead us to the platinum age, and will lead us to the era of light and life afterwards. The planet is ready to ascend. I also wanted to, before I comment on that painting behind me, I wanted to make a little comment. Is that in general, if there are people things, but people in your life that are constantly bringing you into, that are constantly bringing you into chaos, that are bringing conflict and drama. Know that certain people are feeding on that. They're solely concentrated on the false ego, and those you need to cut them out of your life. You cannot allow yourself to waste your spiritual energy, to your time with people and things that are people that are not ready to embrace that joy, if that's what you seek. For of course, we have to be tolerant and loving. In essence, once we move into a higher plane of consciousness, we see the Supreme Being within all things, all beings. Not only all things, but within all beings, it can be reflected within all human beings. But it is very well hidden within the false ego personality. Most human beings are absolutely unconscious of that divine presence within themselves. But as you tune into your own presence, you will see it in all other beings, and you will be able to communicate on a superconscious level. You will be able to get insight into all things at any time. Anytime you meet someone else, or you see someone else, or their spirit will send you messages. And so that's a little bit maybe more advanced. For anything it depends really our level of reality, consciousness, how we use things depend on where we are and what we seek. So with all those messages, I try to guide, to inspire, share my thoughts and ideas in relationship to what works for me. But only use what makes sense to you. For we are unique and different. Life is tailor-made for us, and slowly but surely we are being faceted to become more, to become. Immortal, eternal, and finite consciousness eventually. So that is the whole process of the universe, the whole company of heaven is involved in forging, in making help, assisting in unfolding this the new energy, so that the divinity within ourselves can be more present, more revealed, until we are finally anchored eternally within that great presence of God within ourselves. So I wanted to briefly comment on this painting. This painting is a painting of the 100 major planets of our solar system. In essence, there is 10 major planets that have been used in astrology. The Sun is the Solaris, Solara, the logo, the solar logo is the collective soul. It is the center of it all in on the physical plane. Then we have Mercury, which is when you are in unity consciousness and you are in a state of serenity, it is the messenger of the Sun. It will help you integrate each and every moment what the Sun is giving. But the mind can also, the lower mind, the human mind can also be. Can also work against us once we are working solely in duality. It is always keeping us in a labyrinth inside, entrapped into a cycle that do not elevate itself. So Mercury is Hermes, is the messenger of Zeus, he's got this ambivalent energy. So Mercury is definitely a planet to work with as we are. But I understand that not all the things of the mind are real and true. We want to move. There is a lot of illusion that are being supported, and so as we let go of some of those illusions, we can replace it by higher truths, and from there, Mercury will be the faithful messenger of the Sun. Then we have the planets Mars and Venus. Of course, there is the Gaia and Luna here, the Earth and the Moon. Earth, Sun, and Moon are creating this balance of energy. So then there is Venus and Mars, which is the divine masculine and divine feminine. Venus is our likes and dislikes. It will be the initiator of the light body. It is the goddess Aphrodite, the goddess of beauty. And Mars is the Eris. Of course, all those planets have a Latin name for the most part. Some of them are Greek names, but they're all connected to those old energies of. And Mars is a much more. Of course, all those beings have ascended. They're not anymore what they were portrayed in mythology. They're far greater now. They're far more universal. They have expanded into universal consciousness, and so they are assisting us. They're here to return to us those power. Those as you commune and connect to those planets on a personal level, you will be able to. to be informed and to be guided and to allow the your own self-empowerment to happen. So Mars is very much our willpower. It is our sexual nature. It is a very raw power that has to be sometimes tamed and sometimes asserted. It all depends on the moment. Of course, the four great influence of the most powerful influence of the solar system are Jupiter, Saturn, Neptune, and Uranus. So Jupiter is the biggest planet of our solar system. It is the great Zeus, the king of it all, the king of them all. Yet it is fully harmonized with the Saturn. So it is a planet of expansion. It is a planet of miracle. It is a planet of that makes anything is possible once you are connected to that magic power of that crystallization power of your thoughts and desire. And Jupiter will allow that to make it happen. Saturn is the great teacher, is the Kronos, which is also a little planet named Kronos, but through this little planet, this great spirit rules over these great systems of world. It is one of the most magnificent planets of our solar system. It is with great mysteries that will be unveiled about all those worlds about the solar system in the future. For it is the master of time, it represents the past, it represents the karmic relationship we have to life. Then Uranus is the future. It is the Uranus, the sky, the one that expands into something else. It is the future. And then Neptune is the world of dream. It is a very mystic planet. Of course, Neptune is. It is the energy of Poseidon. Uranus is the Uranus, the great father, the Kronos and Jupiter. And then there is the planet Chiron. That's also an essential planet. It's an essential planet because it was a center, the wounded healer, but it's also the one that has the wisdom. And it bridges, its orbit is between Saturn and Uranus, so it is the bridge between the past and the future. It brings into alignment, and it is a very, very powerful, very fast energy. It's of a very high consciousness. And then there are countless other smaller planets that are very, very important. If you can connect to a Nomia, for instance, it is the divine order. If you invoke the power of that planet, it will bring you back into alignment. The planet Ebe is the planet of eternal youth. Once you connect to that, you can bring the nectar within your life and regenerate all your cellular process with just that connection to that amazing planet Ebe. On a little personal note, I was rereading the Bhagavad Gita, the great book of Hindu wisdom, and Lord Krishna was saying that even as mortal beings, we can enjoy the ambrosia, and which is the same words that has been used in Greek mythology to describe the food of the gods. So it is, all of it is really highly connected. And there is all kinds of force. Euphrosyne is also a wonderful planet to connect to, for it is the joy, it is the purity of enjoyment of life. Yet there are planets that you want to deactivate within yourself, like Tisiphon. It is the planet of vengeance, there is some darker energies that could be at play. So but in a sense, you want to connect to all that is good, and without having to refuse the energies of the others, for they may affect you. But essentially, they are planets that. They all have a function. They all have attribution. Like here, the Hector, the planet Hector, which is the triumphant return. It is the greatest hero of the War of Troy, the great Hector. Or there is all kinds of other planets that have all kinds of energetic function. For in terms of medicine, there is Asclepius and. And where is the other one? But there's many. Asclepia is the goddess of medicine. Then Panacea is a goddess that heals with plants. Admetos is also a great healer. Of course, Chiron. Admetos was able to resurrect the dead. So it's very, quite powerful. Then there is. Where is it? The hiding. The one. And of course, many of them are being called with a Latin name, but in essence, the connection is here made through the Greek name of those planets. Although if you call on Saturn, it will be Kronos that will respond to that. Well, Hygieia is also a very powerful planet of medicine. Then there is all kinds of all those planets. I've already discussed some of those planets in the past video, so I just wanted to share that with you. And then of course there is Pluto, the lord of the underworld, the one that brings about the transformation. So it is very important to allow ourselves to let go of all those lower aspects so that we can move into something new, something fresh, something lighter, to move from we are always moving from, we're seeking to move from dark to light, from heavy to light, to from the impure to the pure. In order to, when we, if we are seeking that ascension, otherwise there is no right or wrong. It all depends on our own personal choice. I'm going to pull out a few cards for the day. The highest wisdom we can receive today is the higher self. The higher self is what we need to connect to. It is our soul. It is our group soul. It is our guides. It is connected. It is what we need to involve, to connect to it, all these invisible forces that drive our life from the inner plane. It is really what we need to connect, to learn to connect, to trust that higher self. What is we need to understand is achievement. We need to achieve that connection. We need to achieve certain things. And so we are working in that relationship to achieve that, to make this achievement possible. What we need to do is the pathfinder. It means finding the way on the earth, finding the way that makes it possible to achieve that. And so we have guides that are higher guides, spirit guides, spiritual guide, and we have pathfinder guide, which is the guide that will lead us to. Of course, you can always call on to your guardian angel, which is he or she, depending, is always able to assist you in no matter what the circumstances are. It is the closest of all spirit that, except for that of the source, it is the closest spirit that that is always with you. And the key, the general message for us today is surrender, letting go of attachment, letting go of all those things that create discordance. That if we can let go of those things and focus on that joy, on that fulfillment, on that achievement, then we'll be in a lot more state of appreciation, and things will flow. We'll be more in a state of gratitude, and from that state of gratitude, so much more will come. Well, I hope this message was interesting for you. I'm going to finish with a song. It's a song that was written by a French person that was called, what was his name? Claude François. But the lyrics in English are more powerful, so I'm going to sing it in English. The words in English is by Paul Anka. It's a song that's called My Way. It goes like this. And now the end is near, and so I face the final curtain. My friend, I'll say it clear, I'll state my case, of which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full, I've traveled each and every highway, and more, much more than this, I did it my way. Regrets, I've had a few, but then again, too few to mention. I did what I had to do, and so it's true without exemption. I've planned each charted course, each careful step along the byway, and more, much more than this, I did it my way. Yes, there were times I'm sure you knew when I bit off more than I could chew. But through it all, when there was doubts, I hit it up and spit it out. I faced it all and I stood tall and did it my way. I've loved, I've laughed and cried, I've had my fear, my share of losing, and now as tears subside, I find it all so amusing. To think I did all that, and may I say, not in a shy way. Oh no, oh no, not me, I did it my way. For what is a man? What has he got? If not himself, then he has not. To say the things he truly feels, and not the words of one who kneels. The record shows I took the blows and did it my way. Well, thank you very much. I wish you a wonderful day. I send my blessings, and I'll speak to you later. Namaste.